Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar is well known for his contribution in drafting of the Indian Constitution. He is also remembered as one of the builders of modern India. An eminent lawyer and a leader of the Indian people, he was intimately connected with the upliftment of the depressed classes. There was yet another side to his personality, recognized in his native Maharashtra, but not fully known to everyone in India. Baba Sahib, as he was popularly called, was also an educationist. He started a movement for the education of the deprived, the downtrodden, and the poor. Like Mahatma Phule, Baba Sahib was convinced that the problem of the depressed classes was due entirely to their lack of education. Beginning with school education, Baba Sahib went on to establish a number of colleges all over Maharashtra for providing education to the poor. Baba Sahib's educational program was not only for the scheduled castes, but for all the depressed and poor people of India. Mr. Shankar Rao Kharat recalls Baba Sahib's views on education.
When he started his movement at Mahad in 1927, and before depressed classes, audience, he preached them, he told them, explained them the importance of education. And because through education, we shall make a social change. Through education, we can even reconstruct the whole Indian society on new principles, the principles of liberty, principles of equality, and principles of fraternity.
These views came as a reaction to the kind of education that was introduced and propagated by the British in India.
Dr. Baba Sahib Ambedkar has criticized the British policy of education. And he said that the British policy of education is only for classes and it is not for masses. Why it is not for masses, he said. Then he gave one example. In 1855, lower caste people from Ahmednagar, they made an application to British government that they wanted to start a school for a lower classes in Ahmednagar. They are prepared to build one classroom, and secondly, they prepared to give half of the pay or half of the salary of the teacher. But even then, the request of these lower caste people were not accepted by the British people. Even Mount Stuart Elphiston have got the same policy. He has prepared his minutes about educational policy. And he has said that these lower caste people should not be given education. Particularly, he has instructed all missionaries who were imparting education to the lower caste people. If the missionaries took in their hands up this educational problems of the lower caste, and after the education of the lower caste people, they will have to be given some posts in government offices, in educational departments, or in some other departments.
Justice R.R. Bhole is convinced that through education, Dr. Ambedkar wanted to awaken the deprived people to their rights.
Of course, they had no share at all insofar as political participation is concerned. Therefore, Baba Sahib wanted to awaken the people to these rights. So for the purpose of awakening these people, his philosophy was that unless and until the people are educated, until they are given education, they will not be able to know what their rights are. And therefore, he thought that it is better to start some educational institutions, especially the colleges, high schools, and the hostels.
He want education for masses for a social change, because he want a social change to reconstruct the Indian society on new principle or on new basis. He wanted to create a new man through education, because he know the education gives equality. Education, through education, man gets a knowledge, and knowledge to him, Dr. Ambedkar, knowledge, according to Dr. Ambedkar's opinion, knowledge is a great power.
It was this philosophy of education which he presented to the Simon Commission and through a memorandum to the Round Table Conference in London.
So, in Simon Commission, when he was interviewed before Simon Commission, he has strongly put up this view before this commission. This is one thing. In his memorandum, he gave to, in the Round Table Conference in 1931, Dr. Ambedkar, he was one of the representatives called for a Round Table Conference along with other Indian leaders.
Dr. Ambedkar worked on his philosophy of education throughout his life. He had an integrated plan for primary education, secondary education, as well as college and university education.
So about primary education, say, he wanted to have a primary education, that is education for masses. So he wanted to implement his idea, to bring into operation or into practice this idea. So he started in 1924, maybe in July, one organization of depressed classes people. The name of the organization is Bahishkrit Hitkarani Sabha, Depressed Classes Educational Institute.
The underlying principle of Baba Saheb's philosophy of education for the depressed people was the creation of a network of hostels.
In 1924, to give education for the masses, he started hostels for these depressed classes students, for exploited classes students, for a common man, for common man students. He started hostels. One hostel was started at Panvel, second hostel was started at Thana, third hostel was started at Solapur.
Actually, the hostels for the poorer section of the community, especially the reserve category boys, is very necessary. They come from very poor families. They come from a place where they have hardly anything to reside. They have no houses worth the name. They live something like shelters only. Therefore, all the amenities, facilities, environmental surroundings, which are necessary for a successful prosecution of the education, are practically nil to them. It is in this background of circumstances that these people need these handicaps to be overcome. And for the purpose of overcoming all these handicaps, Baba Saheb thought that hostels are very necessary for such students of the poor community.
Having experimented with the primary education, Baba Saheb quickly went on to create a number of colleges for the education of the poor.
Then Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar started People's Education Society to give higher education, that is a college education, to the depressed classes students. And he has drafted the aims and objects in the Constitution of People's Education Society are as follows.
To provide facilities for education of the poor, to create and foster a general interest in education among the scheduled castes, and in particular to give them facilities, scholarships, freeships for higher education in India and abroad.
Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar started a People's Education Society. So, he started a Siddharth College of Arts, Siddharth College of Commerce, Siddharth College of Science in Bombay. Again, these colleges were started in 1946 in Bombay. with the help of these colleges, of course only scheduled caste or depressed classes students were not admitted in this college. It was these colleges were open to all. Even I may tell you, the first principal of this college was a Sanskrit scholar, Principal Gajendra Gadkar. Dr. Ambedkar has a great, he was a man of giving a quality education. So he appointed teachers or a professor in his college who were learned in their own subjects, who were expert in their own subjects, and who can give a or impart a very good education to all students. But by the by, because of these colleges started by People's Education Society, depressed classes students could get a chance to come to the college. They were given facilities of hostels. Siddharth Vihar, about 300 students hostel is started, and the depressed classes students, they have taken benefit of these hostels, and many students from depressed classes, they have taken higher education in arts, in science, and in commerce, and in laws also.
We have people from Madras, we have teachers from Madras, we have people from North, teachers from North. In that way, we represent in among us the teaching staff, teachers from all over the country. Then from the, so far as the students is concerned, students from all over the country. Therefore, this was a very big, I think, advantage in having a college in Bapu. Unfortunately, because Baba Sahib started the college, many good people and thinking people also thought, and even one or two governors who have come here thought that this was meant only for the scheduled caste people or the backward class people. This is absolutely a wrong idea. Baba Sahib was of the view that education should not only be given to the untouchable classes, scheduled caste, backward classes, but to all the poorer classes. And therefore, we have in fact the teachers, majority of whom are from the non-reserved category. And among the students also, as I told you earlier, they are from all over the country, and largely from people who are poor, who are from the rural area.
This was also the beginning of a novel experiment in college education carried out for the first time in India.
I must tell you another thing. We were the first, Baba Sahib was the first person to start morning colleges in Bombay. In fact, in the whole of the state of Bombay. And we had terrible opposition from the University of Bombay and also from all the Western Indians. We started morning colleges for the purpose, with a set purpose. And that set purpose was that all the persons who are earning their bread, who are employed elsewhere, should get education. And therefore, we started morning colleges so that these earning members, these service people would come to the morning colleges and get their studies and become graduates and become college.
Over the years, Dr. Ambedkar became fully convinced that the only answer for the upliftment of the backward, the downtrodden, and the poor people in this country was through education.
And when the first president of independent India, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, came to Aurangabad, who laid the foundation stone of the Milind College, at that time, that is in 1951, in the month of September, Dr. Ambedkar said in his speech,
"Coming as I do from the lowest order of the Hindu society, I know what is the value of education. The problem of raising the lower order is deemed to be economic. This is a great mistake. The problem of raising the lower order is not to feed them, to clothe them, and to make them serve the higher classes as the ancient ideal of this country. The problem of raising the lower order is to remove from them that inferiority complex which has stunted their growth and made them slaves to others, to create in them the consciousness of the significance of their lives for themselves and for the country, of which they have been cruelly robbed by the existing social order. Nothing can achieve this purpose except the spread of higher education.
So about university education, he has got his strong view. So according to views, from the beginning to this end, taking into account the Indian society or the construction of Indian society, he was against theory of percolation in education. So a British theory of education was there would be percolation, that is from higher to lower order. But Dr. Ambedkar was against this theory. He said in a caste-ridden society in India, this theory of percolation is not true. He is against the construction of a society which is a caste-ridden society.
Mr. Ghanshyam Talwatkar, one-time registrar of the Siddharth College and an associate of Dr. Ambedkar, recalls how Baba Sahib paid attention to every aspect of the college administration.
Although Dr. Ambedkar belonged to the scheduled caste community or a depressed class community, but he has kept the all institution open for all the caste and communities. He had a feeling that it should be a sort of a project for nation building project. So he had kept portals of this institution open to all the class and caste.
Dr. Ambedkar was himself a great scholar. Mr. Rege, the first librarian of the Siddharth College, remembers Baba Sahib as a lover of books and a voracious reader.
Now you find Rajagura was a building which he built for his library. In Rajagura in 46, there were about 23,000 books, all personal books. And then later, when he went to Delhi, and he was all the while for major portion of his later life, he was in Delhi, he had collected about 10,000 books there in Delhi household. Now, a man to possess such a big collection, and big in the sense that it was absolutely a rich collection, books practically on almost all subjects. No subject was taboo to him, mm-hmm. because as you know, he was actually a student of knowledge in a way, and he always loved books more than anything else.
Yeah.
And when I asked him once, I say, why all this thing about him? He says, in my childhood, I was deprived of owning a book, and I started, whenever I had money, I wanted to have a book of my own. He would see how rich he was as far as knowledge was concerned all around him. And that is how one people might say that he was, this was a madness,
yes.
to buy so many books at a time,
yes.
and keep them, possess them. You know, Birla had, before that, Malvi had offered, knowing about his collection, 2 lakhs of rupees he had offered to get all those books for the Banaras Hindu University,
yeah.
which he refused. And later, after a few years later, Birla had offered 6 lakhs of rupees for the same collection again. And Dr. Ambedkar said, nothing doing.
In whatever he did, Dr. Ambedkar looked for the best.
Well, standards and values, you see, they are well known. Dr. Ambedkar was always for the best of the law, best of the things in life, as well as in administration of the society. Therefore, he chosen very reliable professors belonging to different caste communities. They were Parsis, they were Christians, they were all the caste Hindu people. All these people came from Khalsa College, which was also, he was instrumental to start Khalsa College. Earlier, about 40, I don't remember the exact year, but the number of students and the professors who were in Khalsa College, they came en bloc to the P.C. Siddhartha College after this college was started. He had a different, the temperament. He wanted to build up the nation through the medium of institutional work.
Dr. Ambedkar advocated all-round development of the students in his college.
So, and he had engaged no less a person than P. Vitthal, also one may say scheduled caste, but not scheduled caste, merely scheduled because he was scheduled caste. He was engaged as he was the first captain of the Hindu cricket team as a coach for cricket, and our college cricket team continuously for about 11 years was the champion. That was because of this. But Dr. Ambedkar had established scholarships for the cricketers, for the sportsmen, for the other people who take part in other activities and all that. And we had actually engaged a coach who would go out and watch the talents at the school level and bring the boys to our team. So that was his personal interest.
He was a perfectionist in whatever he did, and he expected this quality from his teachers as well as the students.
Yes, now you know Ambedkar was in a way a perfectionist. Whatever he wanted to do, he wanted to do it foolproof to the last.
Baba Sahib went on to conceive of a school for legislators and members of parliament.
So he had, during the almost the last years of his life, he had a thought of opening a sort of a training school. And the name was Training School for Entrance to Politics. He started that in August 56.
Yeah.
Now he told me that this is my personal venture. Society or college has nothing to do with it. I am the director, and he had appointed me as a registrar of it.
Unfortunately, his last dream of a school for education in democracy could not be realized. Baba Sahib was snatched away from us by his untimely death in 1956. But his contribution to Indian education lives on. Hundreds of thousands of young men and women from the poorer sections of our society have received quality education because Baba Sahib had the vision of upliftment through education. Hundreds of institutions presently flourish all over the country, carrying forward the ideals of Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar, who dreamt of an India where education would lead to liberty, equality, and fraternity.